Hello, I am an IVF patient and I am also a nurse educator and a registered nurse. And something that's really bothered me ever since I've been undergoing IVF treatments has been that the clinics, at least some of them, I'm sure, still are educating their patients to do their intramuscular injections on their dorsogluteal, which is back here. And the problem with that site is that there is the sciatic nerve that runs pretty close to that injection site. So you end up having a much higher risk of inadvertently injuring yourself and potentially causing even permanent damage and sciatic pain for the rest of your life. And the fact is that there's a better option. There's been a lot of studies debunking the use of the dorsogluteal muscle. Nonetheless, a lot of clinics still use it. A lot of nurses still use it even, maybe because they don't know better. But the preferred injection site for intramuscular injections, especially ones that need to go into a larger muscle, are actually going to be the ventrogluteal, which is on the hip area. So when I started doing my own IM injections for IVF, I looked online because I was like, I know I can find this muscle on another person, but it requires you to put your hands on their hip and you can't do it to yourself is the problem. So I was like, okay, I gotta figure out how to find these landmarks on myself and where to do this injection. I would have loved to have a video of somebody going through this, but nobody had one, at least not a good one that I could find. So this is my demo video for anybody out there who's doing intramuscular injections on yourself, whether it's for IVF or other hormone replacement therapies or steroids or whatever. This is my recommendation, is to use your ventrogluteal, not your dorsogluteal. So the ventrogluteal muscle, like I said, it's kind of in the hip region. It's actually comprised of your gluteus minimus and your gluteus medius. So it's two different muscles that make up that, what we call the ventrogluteal muscle. The landmarks that we're looking for is gonna be the front of your hip. That's called the anterior superior iliac spine. And then we follow that along to the iliac crest here, all the way in the back. So you're kind of like marking mentally or whatever with your fingers, feeling for these bony landmarks, the front of your hip and the back of your hip, where it's kind of at its peak. And then the third landmark is your femur bone that sticks out here when you kind of pop your hip out. That femur bone is the greater trochanter. And those are the bony landmarks that you're looking for. You're kind of making a triangle with that. So I've actually marked on my own skin so you can see this. So I'm just gonna pull my pants down and pull underwear up so that you can see a little bit. Okay. And as you can see, I have a little bit of bruising here, but here's my front landmark, my back landmark, and my femur greater trochanter right there. Okay. So how we want to inject on a muscle is when the muscle is most relaxed. So how do you relax this muscle is actually by either sitting or laying down and slightly bending your knee a little bit is going to make that muscle nice and squishy. So I like to do it sitting, especially because I'm doing these on myself. So let me get in position here. Okay, so I'm sitting. I've still got my bony landmarks. I can feel them again. The greater trochanter kind of gets mushed away by, you know, you got fat or muscle here that makes it difficult to feel once you're in this relaxed position. But you want this nice kind of squishy area right in between these landmarks. I have injected a little further toward the front of my body. And when I've done that, I've accidentally hit, there's a ligament there that kind of gives me a shocky feeling, and I don't love that. So I recommend to err on the, a little bit on the, more toward the back of yourself so that you don't hit that ligament. So far, I haven't had any permanent damage from doing that. So I'm gonna cleanse the site here. And something I didn't put nearby me, but you might wanna have are cotton balls, because every now and then you might hit like a superficial bleeding vein that does make it bleed a bit. But as you can see, my bruising isn't too bad. It's been okay. All right, so let me change my angle here so you can see actual injection. So I got my nice squishy spot. I've already sanitized it, so I don't wanna touch it again. And I'm gonna be going in at a 90 degree angle. This is a 1.5 inch needle. You want the longer needles for this muscle because it's a deep muscle and you wanna get it into the muscle and not just be going into fat, which is what sits on top of muscle. Okay, so we're gonna go straight in. 1, 2, 3, not bad. Now, if your clinic advises you, you can do aspiration. So you can pull back on the plunger a little bit. I don't see any blood, so I'm good to inject. My suggestion is that you inject pretty slow, and because this solution is really thick, you're probably not gonna be able to inject it really fast anyway. So, you know, the rule of thumb in nursing that we teach our students is 0.1 milliliters per second. And I think that's about as fast as you can push this in, at least if you're using a thinner needle too, because the oil is really thick. Then the trick is, my suggestion is to hold the needle in. And I know that sounds really weird, but you're gonna hold it in for another 10 seconds or so. And that's gonna help the medication dissipate into your muscle and not just leak back out. And then we're gonna remove quickly. All right, don't have too much bleeding, just a little dot. Gonna hold some pressure on there. And then you're gonna dispose of your sharp in your sharps that you hopefully got from your pharmacy. Otherwise you'll need to get a sharps container and dispose of properly. Okay, so I'm just gonna hold a little pressure on there. Really, the pain is not bad at all, especially if you inject, like poke quickly and then inject the solution slowly and then remove the needle quickly. You know, those are kind of the keys to reducing pain. If you're slowly pushing the needle in, it's gonna make those nerves hurt more. So you wanna go quick in, slow injection, slow push, and then quick out. And then get your, you know, gauze, or I just using the alcohol swab to hold pressure on here, which is usually just fine. And no, it doesn't really hurt. I know it's alcohol on an open wound, but I've never noticed any like stinging or problems with that. Okay, I hope you found this helpful. Best of luck to everybody out there. For whatever reason you're taking hormone replacement therapy or on these medications, I'm sure it's for a reason. So I hope this was helpful for you.